Hello, GCC students. I am here to welcome you to Chem 130. My name is Dr. Kim Smith, and I am the course coordinator for Chem 130. I may or may not be your particular instructor, by the way. Chem 130 is a safe space, so this class is safe for you. Diversity is very welcome in Chem 130. Respect is mandatory. Everyone here is an equal in your instructor's eyes. All of you matter to your instructors and to me. And if you ever need help, please tell your instructor. You can get in touch with me or a counselor. A little bit about Chem 130. Is it easy? Is it hard? How much math is there? These are the questions I always hear about this course. Well, it is a chemistry course. It's an easier chemistry course, but it's still chemistry, right? Which may be hard for you if you're not very good at science, typically speaking. It is similar to the high school course, except it's in one semester, meaning we go through the material at a very quick pace. As far as the math, there's a little bit of algebra, but for the most part, we just add, subtract, multiply, and divide. So again, just a teeny bit of algebra in this course, which is why algebra is a prerequisite. Chem 130 usually has a very wide variety of students. You may be a nursing major. You might be pre-med. Maybe you're a biology major. Or maybe you're a med tech. You want to be a radiologist. You could be a geology major. Or maybe you're just taking it for fun. But we have a lot of different backgrounds. Some of you just made it through your algebra class, while others of you may have finished calculus. So we have a lot of different backgrounds in Chem 130, a lot of diversity, and that's what makes the course so interesting to teach and so much fun. Make sure you read your syllabus very carefully as soon as you can find it. It should be in your Canvas course somewhere. Make sure you look all over Canvas for your materials. They'll be in modules. We have 15 chapters typically that we cover, and they're in modules in your Canvas course with the textbook and the videos. So you want to look all over Canvas and get familiar with all your materials. By the way, if you never really had to study before, you're going to have to study now for chemistry. About 6 to 10 hours a week for fall and spring semesters, about 15 to 20 hours per week for the summer semester. How should you study chemistry? Well, for science and math courses, it is strongly suggested that you study 30 minutes at a time and then do something else. Either do a non-math or science class like English or history and study that, check email, go watch a video, get on Facebook or Instagram or whatever you do, and then come back later. But do 30 minutes at a time. First, you should always look at the chapter text. Again, read it. The chapters are very short and to the point in Canvas. So read the text first. Then you have videos you can watch to help you with your lecture. We have practice worksheets. Those are not turned in for a grade. The practice worksheets are simply practice problems before you take a quiz or exam or a homework. You might want to read the text again. And by the way, when you read the text, you should be taking notes. They will supplement your notes when you are in lecture or if you're watching the videos. And before that exam or quiz, put all your materials away for 30 minutes beforehand to rest your brain. It is bad to study right up to the exam. Previous students who made A's have said, keep up, study every week, and during summer, almost every day. Study for quizzes and exams. Don't just blow off if you have quizzes in your course. Study for those quizzes as well. Go over the chapter text carefully. I call it OER text. That stands for Open Educational Resource, meaning it's free. It's a free book. You don't have to go to the bookstore and buy a book for this course. It is an open educational resource. It is free to you. Don't miss your class, or if you have Zooms, ever. The more you miss your class or Zooms, the worse your grade is. Plus, you could be withdrawn for attendance issues. Don't cheat. It is not worth it in Chem 130. There's really bad chemistry out on the internet when you Google. So don't do that. Don't Google some of those facts, which are wrong. We'll know you Googled it because you Googled something we're aware of on the internet that's wrong. And then you can get a zero on that assignment. And repeat cheating is cause for you to get a withdraw or even a Y in the whole course. Do ask and email questions. Your to-do list, what you should do immediately. Read that syllabus again. Carefully read the syllabus. Go over the welcome module in Canvas. Make sure you go to class if it's an in-person class the first day. Go ahead and read your textbook chapter one. If you like to write on your book, print it out so you can highlight. That's great if you have access to a printer, or you can go to High Tech 1 or 2 and print the textbook. That way you can highlight and write on it. Look all over Canvas for all your materials in those modules. Get your calculator. Print out the periodic table and the shapes table. Those need to be printed out for sure. Message your instructor with any questions you have. Make sure you go to lab or check into your lab if you're enrolled. And lab is a separate course, by the way. So if you're taking this Chem 130 science course with lab, make sure you've enrolled in the lab so you can go attend the lab and get your credit for your science course with lab. Nursing majors, science majors, pre-med, pre-vent, pre-dental majors all need the lab as well. Here's a picture of two calculators, which are very common in Chem 130. The first one is TI-30XA. It's what I recommend for nursing students. If you do not have to take another chemistry course, this is the one I recommend for you. It's very simple to use. If you are going to take more chemistry courses, like Chem 151, then I recommend the second one that's navy blue, and it comes in different fun colors also, the TI-30X2S. That's the one everyone will have in Chem 151, by the way, is the TI-30X2S. So get that one if you're moving on in chemistry. Some Chem 130 rules if you are taking this class online or live online. Okay, again, this is only for the online sections. Online exams are open note, but you must use the Chem 130 periodic table and shapes table, not other tables, or it could be wrong. The numbers may be a little bit different and you could get answers wrong. So use the table we provide. Googling is simply not allowed. That gives you a zero. You have to stay in the Canvas exam or the log's going to show you clicked away and you get a zero. Note, you can click away in your homeworks or activities, just not quizzes if you have them, and the exams. The exams are going to be timed quickly, so you can't look everything up. You're going to run out of time. You have to know the material. Frankly, with the quick timing, the exams can be pretty tough in the online environment, even though they're open note. You may think, oh, that makes it easy. Not really, not when they're timed as fast as they are. Be aware of the withdrawal policy in an online class. If you have too many missing assignments, you can get withdrawn for that. So again, read your syllabus and read the withdrawal policy. Chem 130 in-person or hybrid rules. In-person exams and quizzes won't have notes. Okay, so no note cards, no little cheating notes. That's all cheating. Don't cheat on an in-person exam. You can't use your phone or smartwatches, no fancy calculators. You can't use a graphing calculator, for example. We will give you a clean Chem 130 periodic table and shapes table to use during the in-person exams or quizzes. You cannot use your own because you've written all over it. So we'll give you a fresh copy. Be aware of the withdrawal policy for an in-person or hybrid class. It will have some attendance requirements and also perhaps missing assignment requirements. So you have to turn in your work and you have to be there in class. It's an in-person class. You must attend. So don't miss class too often or you could be withdrawn. Some exam tips. Regardless of whether you're taking this course online, hybrid, or in person, the exams are timed. So you need to work quickly. How do you work quickly? Well, I'm glad you asked. You do the practice worksheets. So those are practice problems, and you do them over and over again till you get really quick at answering questions. Those will tell you the types of questions you'll see on the exams and quizzes. You'll get used to them, and you'll speed up the process that you think to work on these questions. So the worksheets are great practice problems. The more problems you practice, the higher your grade will be. Breathe deeply, keep track of the time for all exams. So good luck, everyone. Again, message or email your instructor with any questions you have. I welcome you to CHM 130. Bye-bye.